special focus on hip flexors, quads, core strength, and flexibility. So we'll start in an easy pose on the floor. So gently rock from side to side, pulling the flesh away from the sits bones, and allow the backs of the hands to relax on the knees. Gently close your eyes. Feel the shoulders roll back, and the crown of the head reach up toward the sky. As you deepen the breath, create some length through the spine. Feel the chest lift up with the inhale. And create that nice foundation for the practice by reaching the tailbone toward the earth and planting a root for the posture. Gently close your mouth if you haven't already. And begin breathing in through the nose and out through the nose. Finding a warm, stabilizing breath that serves your intention for your practice today. The next inhale, reach the arms up over the head and shift the gaze up toward the sky. Exhale, fold forward, reach the fingertips out in front of you and the forehead toward the earth. Allow the spine to lengthen, inhale. Exhale, walk the fingertips forward one more step. Creating more length, continue to reach the tailbone in the opposite direction. Inhale. Exhale, roll up through the spine, one vertebrae at a time, bring the shoulders up and back. Inhale the arms up, shift the gaze up. This time as you exhale, sweep the arms behind the back, interlacing the fingers at the tailbone, just gently. Don't force too much of a stretch this early in the practice, but just reach the backs of the hands toward the earth and shift the gaze up toward the sky. Inhale. Exhale, release the fingers, round the shoulders forward and back. Reach the arms out, away from the midline. And exhale, pull the right arm across the chest, take the left arm on the outside of the right forearm, just gently pulling, stretching through the upper back. Inhale. Exhale, release it, opening up the chest again. Nice big inhale. Exhale, take it across the body, left arm this time, pulling it in with the right arm, opening up through the upper back. Just creating some length between the spine and the shoulder blade. Inhale. Exhale, release it. Extend the legs out in front of you, flexing the feet, walk the heels away from the hips. Pull the belly in, lift the chest up. As you exhale, scoop out the abs and roll back slowly, using control from the core. Roll all the way back, reach the arms up over the head. Inhale. Exhale, roll up, coming into staff pose, using control from the core, and hinge forward, reaching the fingertips toward or past the toes, keeping the spine fairly straight. Inhale. Exhale, back into a seated position, into staff pose. Inhale. Exhale, sweep out the abs and roll back again. Reach the arms up over the head, let's repeat that. Inhale. Exhale, roll up, sit tall, and hinge forward. Inhale, lift. Exhale, scoop out the abs, roll back, just massaging belly in the back of each movement. Inhale. Exhale, roll up, sit tall, hinge forward. This is much like a Pilates roll up. Inhale, lift up. Exhale, scoop out the abs and roll down. This will be our last one. Inhale. Exhale, roll up, sit tall, and this time from your tall feet, you're going to take the heels apart, coming into a straddle, and bring the palms together, and hinge forward, reaching the palms forward, beginning to create some length through the inner thighs, the hamstrings, relax the forehead. If the forehead touches the mat, that's fine, don't force it. You can even round the back a little on this one if you'd like. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale, roll, lift up. You can keep the spine somewhat straight using the core. We're going to cross the ankles and float through, coming into a table. Let's take a few cat and cow stretches to continue to warm up the core. Inhale, bring the gaze forward, curl the tailbone up toward the sky. Exhale, reverse it, round the back. Inhale, cow pose. Exhale, cat stretch. Inhale, belly down, gaze up. Exhale, reverse it. Inhale, gaze forward. Exhale, reverse it. One more each. Inhale, forward. Exhale, reverse. And bring the spine back to neutral. Reach the hips back. Take the palms forward. Let's come into a child's pose. Relaxing in the child's pose, you can create some space between the thighs and allow the belly to relax between the legs. On the next inhale, curl the toes under, press the hips back, downward facing dog. Relax the ears between the biceps and pedal the feet a few times, walking your dog, making any adjustments needed in the posture. Whenever you're ready, you can reach the heels toward the earth. Reach the hips back, stretching out the calves, the Achilles, the hamstrings. And now we're going to take a nice dynamic warming movement as you soften the knees, shift the gaze forward, bend the knees all the way to the mat, barely touching the mat, and exhale, press it back into a down dog. We're going to do that 10 times. Inhale, knees down, abs in tight. Exhale, press it back. Inhale, lower. Exhale, press it back. Inhale. Down, exhale, down dog. Inhale, down, exhale, back. Inhale, down, exhale, back. Inhale, down, exhale, back. Three more. Inhale, down, exhale, back. Inhale, down. Exhale, back. One more for good measure. Inhale, down. Exhale, back. And go ahead and inch the feet forward, keeping the palms on the ground as long as you can. If you have to lift them up, let the legs get closer to the hands, that's fine. Forward, forward. That exercise or that sequence allows you to kind of create some strength and flexibility in the feet, great for preventing plantar fasciitis and other tightness in the feet. Inhale, sweep the arms up over the head. Exhale, hands to heart, shoulders back, belly and toes together, heels in line with the toes. Coming into mountain pose, gently tuck the hips under and grow tall through the spine. Inhale, sweep the arms up, shift the gaze up. Exhale, sink the hips back, bringing the thighs together, coming into a chair pose. Once you've sunk back into your chair pose, you can gently tuck the hips under and pull the rib cage back. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale, bring the hands to the heart. Straighten the legs, sweep the arms up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, shift the gaze forward. Exhale, deepen the fold. Inhale, sweep the arms up over the head. We're going to go through this sequence a few times, just nice dynamic movement, one breath per posture. Exhale, hands to heart, and sink down in the chair. Inhale, reach the arms up, shift the gaze up toward the sky. Exhale, swan dive forward. Inhale, shift the gaze forward, lengthen the spine. Exhale, deepen the fold. Inhale, sweep the arms up. Exhale, hands to heart, sink down a little lower each time with your chair pose. Inhale, lift up, gaze up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, shift the gaze forward. Exhale, deepen the fold. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, hands to heart, sink down. Inhale, up, reach the arms up. Exhale, swan dive forward. Inhale, shift the gaze forward. Exhale, deepen the fold. And this time, go ahead and step the feet back into a high plank. We'll hold the high plank for 3 breaths, opening up the upper back, keeping the center of the palm as well as the fingertips pressed into the mat to support the wrists. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, step the right foot in between the palms, coming into a crescent lunge. You can gently square off the hips, pulling the right foot back, left hip forward, and feet down. As you hold the crescent lunge, lift the kneecap up on the back leg, creating more length in the back leg, deepening the stretch through the hip and the quad. Inhale. Inhale, bring the hands to the heart, lift the chest up, shoulders back, core engaged. On the next inhale, shift the gaze up, reach the palms up. Exhale, fold forward, frame your foot. Inhale, step the right foot back to meet the left. Inhale, bring the left foot in between the palms, coming into the crescent lunge. Take deep breaths to square up the hips. Sink them down a little lower. Pull the kneecap up. Inhale. Exhale. On the next inhale, lift the chest up. Balancing in your crescent lunge, belly in, tall spine. Inhale, reach the arms up, shift the gaze up. Exhale, bring the hands back down to frame the foot. Left foot goes back to meet the right, high plank. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. And let's take our first chaturanga of the practice. Elbows in, lower down. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Pedal the feet a few times. Press the chest up towards the thighs to lengthen the spine. On the next inhale, sweep the right leg toward the sky, coming into a three-legged dog. Try to square off the hips once you lift the leg up. Bring the heel towards the glutes. Straighten the leg once more. Exhale, heel toward the glutes again. And this time, bring that bent knee toward the nose. Place the foot in between the palms, coming back into the crescent lunge. And on the next inhale, you'll shift the weight onto the right leg. Straightening the right leg, extend the left leg behind you, flex the foot. And we're gonna hold these warrior three legs without adding anything other than this hold right now. We'll keep the fingertips down for support. 2 breaths, inhale. Exhale. Inhale. As you exhale, soften the knees and move back into a crescent lunge. Sweep the arms up, growing as tall through the spine as you can, and then gently arch the back, shifting the gaze up toward the sky. Feel the hip lengthen on the back leg. Inhale. Exhale, fold forward to frame the foot. Step the right foot back and knee to left. If you'd like, you can do a chaturanga again. If you'd like to skip that part, you can go straight back to the down dog. Pedal the feet a few times. Exhale, the chest a little bit closer to the thighs, creating more length in the down dog. Inhale, sweep the left leg up, hip square. Inhale. Exhale, bring the heel toward the hips, feeling more length in the supporting leg. And straighten the leg. Exhale, bring the heel in once more. And this time, following through, bring the knee toward the nose, put the foot next inhale, shift the weight onto the left foot. Square out the hips, flex the foot. Few breaths here, inhale. Shift the gaze up toward the sky, gently arching the back. Bring all that length to the right side of the body this time. One more inhale. Exhale, flip forward to frame the foot. Step the left foot back to meet the right. Hold the high plank, opening up the upper back. Inhale. Exhale, lower to the forearms, coming into a dolphin plank. Try and keep the palms in line with the elbows. Try not to close up and round the back with this one. On the next inhale, begin to inch the feet forward, keeping the gaze between the space between the arms. Practice, gently arch the back, gentle back bend. Once again, lengthening through the bottom hip. Inhale. Exhale, hands to the heart, lifting the posture up, lengthening the spine. Gently rotate through the spine, bringing the left elbow across the thigh and the hands back toward the heart center. Gentle spinal twist. Nice massage of the internal organs. Inhale, release the twist. Exhale, frame the foot. Curl the toes under, lifting up. Step the right foot back to meet the left. You can chaturanga here if you'd like, or you can go straight back into your down dog. Inhale, sweep the left leg toward the sky. Open up the hip, drop the heel down, modify scorpion, keep the shoulders square. Inhale. Exhale, bring the left knee in between the palms, lifting that foot down, and lower the knee down, flatten out the foot. Bring the hands up to the heart, shoulders back, nice tall posture. Reach the arms up, take the gaze up, and if it's in your practice, gently arch the back. Gentle back bend, just allowing your body to guide you and tell you when to stop. Inhale. Exhale, pull the posture up and bring the hands to the heart, tall through the spine. We'll take that right elbow across the left thigh. Inhale. Exhale. begin your practice on the exhale, you can lower down into chaturanga, or you can go straight back into your down dog. From the down dog, soften the knees and shift the gaze forward. You can step or you can hop to the top of the mat, forward fold. Inhale, sweep the arms up over the head. Exhale, hands to the heart. Bringing yourself into Tadasana, toes together, heels in line with the toes, shoulders back, belly in. On your next inhale, you get a nice cleansing exhale, first kind of emptying out the lungs. As you inhale, we're going to come into a single leg balance, using our right leg to balance first. You'll press the palms together, reach them up over the head, and lift the left knee up, reaching the tailbone toward the earth. And bring the hands back to the heart, lowering it down. You're going to inhale and switch sides. Exhale, bring it in. Inhale, other side. Exhale, pull it in. Inhale. Exhale. Take the gaze with you. Inhale up. Exhale, pull it in. One more, inhale it up. Exhale in, and you're gonna sit back into your chair, reaching the arms up, thighs together, knees over the ankles, taking it a little lower this time if you can. Inhale. As you exhale, pull the hands into the heart and lift the heels up, coming onto the toes. Coming into a more advanced posture, if this doesn't feel good, you can stay in your chair pose. You can take it into a child's pose, a plank, or a down dog. Now staying on the balls of the feet, bring the heels and the hips closer together, lowering the hips down, coming into a toe balance, hands to the heart, inhale. Exhale, trying not to relax too much on the heels, keeping some action in the quads and the ankles. One more inhale. Exhale. And on this next inhale, you'll press the heels back to the mat, straightening the legs. Inhale the arms up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, shift the gaze forward. Exhale, deepen the fold. Inhale, step the feet back into a high plank. Nice strong open upper back. And on the next inhale, center the left palm under the chest. We're going to rotate into a side plank. You can always do this from your forearm. Reach the hips up toward the sky, really using the muscles in the obliques. Then take the gaze up toward the top palm. Inhale. Exhale. Also have the option to lower the shin down to the mat. Inhale. Exhale, bring the right palm down, taking it back into a high plank. On the next inhale, we'll take the right palm and center it, on whichever side you didn't already do. Opening up into side plank on the other side, really reaching the hips up toward the sky, having the palm under the shoulder. To a high plank, go ahead and lower the knees down, reach the hips back. We're going to brush through a child's pose, just reaching the tailbone back, and then to roll up one vertebrae at a time, sitting back on the heels, shoulders up and back. Let's interlace the fingers at the tailbone and open up the chest like we did in the beginning of the practice, taking the gaze up. This time, if it's in your practice, roll the hands a few inches away from the tailbone, opening up the chest and shoulders. Inhale. Exhale, bring the hands back by the tailbone, release the fingers, shoulders forward. And we're going to reach forward onto the forearms and step the feet back, coming into a dolphin plank. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, begin to inch the feet forward, really using the core, the On the next inhale, take another half step forward with the feet and brush the right leg up and lower it down. Inhale the left leg up, lower it down, and bend with the knees, lowering the knees down to the mat and come into a table. Relaxing in the table, pull the belly in and lengthen the spine. You're going to reach the right arm forward and the left leg back. Pull the belly in and make the spine as long as you can. We're going to inhale and reach the hand and foot up. Exhale, pull the elbow to the knee. Inhale, reach it up. Nice deep breath. Exhale, pull it in. Really use the abs. Inhale, reach. Exhale, pull it in. Inhale, reach. Exhale, pull it in. One more. Inhale, reach. Exhale, elbow to knee. Bring it back to the table. Let's go right into the other side. Left arm forward, right leg back. Inhale, lift them up. Exhale, elbow to knee. Inhale, reach. Exhale, elbow to knee. Inhale, reach. Exhale, elbow to knee. Inhale, reach. Exhale, elbow to knee. Last one. Pull it in. Bring it to a table. Bring up the chest. Step the feet back. Coming into a high plank. Belly engaged. Inhale. Exhale, bring the left foot to the outside of the left hand. Working on opening up the hip a little bit. Try to keep the back knee lifted and sink the hips down. Reach the top of the head forward, lengthening the neck. Keep the shoulders back. And gently lower the right knee down to the mat and flatten out the foot. If it's in your practice, you can begin to soften the elbows. Maybe lowering the forearms to the mat as you allow the knee to reach closer to the earth and the foot to kind of roll open. There are a lot of fun progressions we can work on with this posture. So thinking about that, this is a great one to practice in your home practice. Warming up with some sun salutations and then stepping into this lizard pose. On the next inhale, press the palms into the mat. This time walking the hands back just another inch. And try to press the hips forward. And on the next inhale, you can flatten the foot. Curl the toes under, lift the knee up. Make sure you have enough space between the palms to have some stability for your upper body. You're going to take your left leg and extend it back, coming into a single leg plank. And let's hold it here for 2 breaths. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. On the next inhale, bring the knee toward the nose. Exhale, step it back into a high plank. And lower the knees down, reach the hips back. Taking a child's pose before we go into the other side. Allow the shoulders to relax. On the next inhale, bring the chest forward, curl the toes under, and lift the knees up, coming into your plank. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, bring the right foot to the outside of the right hand. Just enjoy this stretch for a few breaths. You sink the hips down and lift the left knee up. Inhale. Exhale. One more inhale. As you exhale, you can lower the left knee down, flatten out the foot. Begin to soften the elbows. You can allow the hip to open up as you roll to the side of the foot. Making any modification in between on this posture, or taking whatever posture works for you today in practice. Ready, you can press the palms into the mat. Take it at your own pace, hold it longer if you'd like. Flatten out the foot, curl the toes under, lift the knee up, and whenever you're ready, you can take that right leg and extend it back into that three-legged plank, or one-legged plank, three limbs, one leg.
Inhale. Exhale, tuck the tailbone.
shoulders up and back. While we're at the back of the mat, let's bring the hands to the heart. Bring the toes together and come into mountain pose. We're gonna come into tree pose next. Working on that balancing posture. Whenever you're ready, you can begin to plant some roots by lifting the toes up and pressing them into the mat one at a time. Gripping the mat and relaxing with the breath. Open up the hip on the left side, creating a kickstand, centering the hips. If it's in your practice, you can bring the left foot up to the calf, or you can reach down and assist, pulling your foot up to the inner thigh, bringing the hands back to the center. Finding somewhere to relax the gaze. Shift the focus onto the breath. Balancing in the posture like it's what you are grown to do. One more inhale. As you exhale, you can release the foot and bring the knee into the center. Interlace the fingers around the back as you pull the abs in, taking the fingers around the knee. You can pull the knee up as you pull the chest down, leading halfway. Really engaging through the core. As you exhale, you can lift the chest up and plant the left foot back into the mat. Maybe pedal the feet a few times. Hands at the heart. Rock from front to back. Mix it up however you like. Toes together, heels back. Core engaged. Lift the toes up and plant the roots as we begin tree on the other side. And open up the hip, creating a kickstand, that other foot. Having that root planted, begin to bring the foot to the calf, or assist the foot up to the inner thigh, avoiding pressing into the knee, hands back to the heart. Staying relaxed, focus on the breath. Try not to pay much attention to any differences at this point. We often shift our focus to the differences in the body, but right now, it's just about relaxing in the posture. Rotate the knee forward, taking the foot away from the thigh, interlace the fingers, and use the core, pull the belly in, bringing the knee closer to the chest, and the chest closer to the knee. And whenever you're ready, with much control, release the position. And pedal the feet. Bring the hands to the heart. Sweep the arms up over the head. Inhale. Exhale, swan dive forward. Inhale, as you shift the gaze forward, walk the palms forward as well. Coming into a high plank. On the inhale, reach the left leg up, taking it up a little bit higher than before. Inhale the knee toward the nose and set it back into a high plank. Inhale the right leg up, really creating strength on the left hip, length on the right. Exhale the knee to the nose. Inhale back to high plank. Hold the high plank for a breath. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, set the right foot in between the palms, drop the left heel down and straighten the front leg. Let's forward fold over that front leg, relaxing in the hamstrings. Allow the upper body to relax. If you've got the flexibility to where your palms are reaching the ground, you can gently alternate, stretching through the wrist by flipping the back of the palm to the mat. gently stretching through the back of the wrist, not forcing anything. If you don't quite reach and you have a prop, like a yoga block, egg, or towels, you can do that on your prop. On the next inhale, begin to peel the chest up, engaging through the core. Reach the arms out in front of you. Balance again, that hamstring stretch. Inhale. Exhale. One more inhale. Exhale. Bring the palms back to frame the foot. Soften knee, step the left foot back. Coming through a crescent lunge, you can step the right foot back. Coming back to your high plank. And on the next inhale, bring the left foot in between the palms. Drop the right heel down and forward fold over the left leg. You can just relax in the fold, or you can continue to stretch through the back of the wrist, whatever works for you. And allow the head to relax, reach the forehead toward the knee. On the next inhale, begin to lift the chest up, reach the arms forward. Keep the neck long, reaching the crown of the head toward the future, gazing toward the earth. Inhale. Exhale, fold forward, frame the foot. Step the right foot back, coming through the crescent lunge. Left foot goes back to meet the right, holding the high plank. On the next exhale, you can lower the knees down. Cross the ankles and extend the legs out in front of you. We're going to do a few more of the roll-ups that we did at the beginning of the practice so you can notice the difference before we begin our final floor work. Chest lifted, reach the arms out in front of you, pull the belly in, inhale. Exhale, scoop out the abs and recline back slowly using control from the core. Reach the arms up over the head, inhale. Exhale, roll up, seated staff pose, and hinge forward. Inhale, lift. Exhale, scoop out the abs, recline back, arms overhead. Inhale. Exhale, roll up, sit tall, hinge forward. Inhale, lift. Exhale, recline back. Really deeply engaging the belly. Inhale. Exhale, roll up. Sit tall. Inch forward. Sit tall. Inhaling. And one more roll down on the exhale. Arms up over the head. We're going to roll up one more time. This time we'll take our straddle. Inhale. Exhale, roll up into a seated position. Gaze in space between the legs, tall spine, belly in, and as you exhale, hinge forward. Seeing if you can maybe create a larger straddle this time or a deeper fold without forcing it, just seeing if the body naturally relaxes into the posture more. You can flex the feet or point the toes or alternate pointing and flexing. Massaging the ankles. Inhale, lift up. Bring your legs together. Belly in, tailbone under, and roll back. From this position, make the body long. Shoulders wide. And on your next inhale, just peel the chest up and bring the right knee in. Bringing the knee as close to the nose as you can. Rock from side to side, pulling in, watching the knee, bring the knee as close to the nose, point both toes. As you exhale, bring the other knee toward the nose. Inhale. Exhale, switch. Inhale. Exhale, switch. Inhale. Exhale, switch. One more inhale. hinge roll, rolling like a ball until you're up on the tailbone, balancing on the tailbone. Bring the shoulders back. Let's straighten the legs as we inhale. Exhale, pull the knees into the chest. Inhale, reach them back out. If you need to keep a bend in the knees, that's fine. If you can straighten them, that's fine. Back in. Inhale, reach. Exhale, pull it in. Inhale, reach. Tight engagement through the core. Exhale, pull it in. Inhale, reach. Exhale, pull it in. And bring the feet down. Scoop out the abs and roll back. Reach the arms up over your head. And walk your heels out away from the hips. Let's make the body as long as we can. Point the toes. Flex the feet. And bring the arms down by the side. Hands on either side. Pull the shoulder blades together. Bench the heels a little longer. One more time if you can. Go ahead and close your eyes. As you inhale, tighten the fists, curl the toes under. Begin to flex the muscles in the arms and the legs, working your way toward the midline, flexing the chest, the back, belly. To allow some small movement in the fingers and toes. Begin to gently move the arms and legs. As you allow the breathing to return to normal, you can flutter the eyelids, gently bringing them open. Pull the knees in and roll to the left side with little effort as you press yourself into a seated position. Thank you for joining me for our Swan Yoga practice.